Hey everybody, this is Christian Robinson Music, and I'm about to give you a quick tour of my studio. It's not complete yet, but I can give you a tour of what I have so far. I may not have all the brand names and all of the model numbers. I can list that in the description if you want to know more about any piece of equipment. All right, so let's check this out. I'm gonna turn on the light because you won't be able to see much of anything if I do not turn on the light. So, all right, so I have a list of items. They're not in any particular order. So if it's not in a perfect order, don't trip. Let's see. All right, so if you notice, I have the insulation foam. This is not sound treatment. It is not soundproofing. It is just isolation foam. And that foam allows you to deaden the room. And I have the bass traps in all of the corners. And what that is supposed to do is eliminate the bass traps. So the entire room has some treatment, and I really don't have no echo in here. I mean, when I was doing it, I could tell that the reflections were being diminished, and I wasn't even halfway through. So, and with more equipment in here, and with the carpet that I had in here before, I definitely made the room a dead room. And that's what you want as far as vocals. All right, so first up, I have the AKG 420 microphone. This is a brand new microphone. I haven't had it even more than a week. The microphone holder that is in, that's the old holder for my other microphone. But that's the new microphone, the 420. And the stand is an on stand. It's brand new, and it's a heavy duty type of mic stand. So it's not the normal type of mic stand that you would normally see. All right, the headphones that I have, believe it or not, they're not the known brand like you would think. They're Corsairs. Corsairs are not, you know, the best brand in the world. However, it's not about the brand, it's about the frequency response. So basically, I bought these headphones for my video game. And then when I started learning more about the frequency response to 20 hertz or whatever it is, that's only what your ears can hear. So you have to look at the specs when you purchase the headphones. So I've had these old AKG M70s, and the frequency response on them are not that good. So it sounds flat. But the Corsairs, my goodness, I must have liked them enough that I bought three pairs. So they all have a different purpose. One is, you know, for video games, even though it's in here. And then one is for Zoom meeting for my school. And then the other one I purchased for the studio. But right now they're all in the studio. But anyway, I like those headphones. The Corsair headphones are really, really nice. Sounds really good for playback, and it's noise cancellation. So it gives you an incredible sound. All right, so then I have the AKG 200. Now that was the first microphone that I've had for many, many years. There's nothing wrong with this microphone. So I basically have that in the new holder. So that's the holder that came with the 420. The I forgot what you call it, but basically, you know, it suspends the microphone. I can't think of the name of it at the moment. And then there's another onstage microphone stand, which is identical to the first one. But the difference with this one is this is a new base and the threads were different. So I purchased the correct base, but it didn't fit. So they gave me my money back for the base and I had it welded. So there's nothing wrong with this microphone stand. Thanks to Terrell, he gave me this microphone stand and I basically had it welded with the new base and everything is good. So this is not the microphone that would sit in the studio. I would put this in the hallway if someone was gonna sing and I didn't want them in the studio for whatever reason. But I use this microphone when I sing. So, you know, it prevents me from having to walk all the way over here because that's what I was doing. I mean, it's not a big deal, but this is a little closer to me. All right, and next we have the Mo XF8, which is an 88 keyboard. It's not a Motif, but it's a Yamaha Mo XF8. This is one of the latest keyboards. I've had this for many years, so I don't know if they have a new one or not. So this is the latest one that they had at that point in this series. Then we talk about the MPC Renaissance. So I've had this Renaissance for a couple of years. I know how to work an MP. I had an MP 2000. I had to sell it many, many years ago. And then I currently have another MPC 1000 that I don't use for the studio any longer. And I'm still trying to learn how to use this MP within, you know, my workflow. So it's fully work, you know, functional. It works good. But I haven't fully made it a part of my production. Okay, and then we have the monitors. Now remember the difference between monitors, which is video monitors, and then monitors, which are audio monitors. So we have the speakers, Yamaha HS8. So that's what these are. I've had these for a while, but they're pretty much still new, even though I've had them for a while because I was pushing my Elise's 7.0. What is it? The Elise's 7 points or whatever it was. I had those. Those were, I think, five inch. So I wasn't really pushing these HS8s. So to me, they're still brand new. They don't have a scratch on them, you know. And but now the role is reversed. They're the main speakers now. And then the KRK10s. Those were, you know, to give me more bass and more, you know, more sound. So, yeah, with them together, yeah, they're a beast. Okay, I have the HS8 sub as well. And what I plan on doing, I know it sounds crazy, I plan on getting the KRK10 sub. I don't know if it's a 10 or not, but I plan on getting the sub to match because this HS8 matches my HS8 monitors, if that makes any sense. Okay, then I have the Axiom 49 keyboard. I had that over here on top of this one recently. So like I said, everything is still in construction and I'm still trying to figure out, you know, where I want things to be. And right now I'm running out of USB ports. And it's not so much running out of the ports, it's I know that having so many USB ports connected to one computer could cause problems. So that's another USB connected to the computer. So I'm not sure if I'm going to use this forever. So I just put it here just to see how it goes. And I used to have the keyboard set next to me, to the left of me, and I moved it over. So recording is kind of crazy. So that allows me to at least have some keys closer to me so I don't have to keep going back and forth if I need to do something very simple. So I kind of like it there for now. I just put it there yesterday, but I'm not sure if it's going to stay there. The reason why I bought this desk, which let me see. Yeah, it's coming up. The reason why I bought this desk is so I can have more desktop space. So if I put something on the desktop, then I'm kind of going in the opposite direction of what I wanted. I wanted to have space, just to have space. Now this is just a security monitor so I can keep track of my deliveries, right? So this is not going to stay there forever. But yeah, I just wanted more desktop space than I had before. All right, so underneath I have, you can't see it, you know, really. I have this Sabrent 10 port power USB hub, and I only got one more open port for it, but I can cheat because these hard drives that I had that I wasn't really going to talk about, I have two open port USB ports where I can use those if I need to. But yeah, I only got one port left on the Sabrent, and I believe, let me take a peek. Yes, I have one more port on my iMac. So, you know, I have basically, you know, maxed out as much as I can with USBs. Anyway, so now we talk about the Argosy studio desk. I always wanted a professional studio desk. I am not a big fan of the rack mount version of the Argosy because this is, you know, I don't have that much outboard gear, so I didn't want a desk that had the racks on either side. Even though I could have used it for the shelf for the speakers, that's the reason why I wanted it, but I didn't know how the height was going to play into it. I didn't know how the monitors was going to play into it. So I just decided to get the flat desk. It was less expensive than the other ones, but that's not the reason why I bought the flat desk. My studio is really based on monitors, and if you haven't counted, that's six of them, and they're all working off of one computer, and I can tell you later how I was able to make that happen. So that's six independent monitors working off of one iMac, an older iMac. All right, then we talk about the Focusrite Clariant interface. So most of this equipment is fairly new, and you really can't tell the difference between the old equipment I had and the new equipment, but this one is definitely new. I had the Liquid 56 from Focusrite, and there was really nothing wrong with it. The only difference is it was connected using the Thunderbolt, and I wanted one using the USB, so therefore I could use the Thunderbolt cable for the touchscreen monitor that I used to have, but I took it back. I changed my mind. I'll talk about that in a moment. So I basically, you know, didn't need to get the USB one, but I'm sure that this interface, which is newer, is way faster and way better than the last one that I had. Well, I still have it, but you know, it's no longer in the studio. Let me see. So the power supplies, I'm not sure 100% of the make. I think they're called technical or whatever they, you know, I don't know what the make is. I can research it and put it in the description. But it says Technical Pro PS9U. So these are the power supplies. So every piece of equipment in the studio except two of the hard drives and the 43-inch monitor, everything else is connected to this device, including the power strips. So I basically control everything here, which is cool. And Underneath there is the Furman. And that model is an M-8x2 Furman. And it's a power conditioner, by the way. All right, and then I have the iMac 27 inch. I have three identical Dell 27 inch monitors, two on either side. And this one is a fairly new monitor, but this monitor is really for my security system. But I borrow it for other purposes. But there's nothing really stopping me from going to get another 27 inch Dell, the same model, and put it there. But I'm not sure what the size of this. I'm going to guess that it's either 21 inch or 17. I don't know without using a tape measure. It may be 21 inch. So that's fine for what I'm going to use it for. So that brings me to the AOC. So what I'm going to use it for is I'm going to have a digital mixer here. And then whatever the digital mixer display on the computer, I'll have it displayed there. Just like I have the MP software being displayed on that monitor right there, I'm going to do the exact same thing. And far as the 27-inch iMac, what you see there is just the MIDI ports. So you just see the different things that I have plugged in. It's just showing you those MIDI ports. And this is just the interface for the Clariot. All right. And then I have this four-port headphone jack. But I'm going to talk about that again in a second for equipment that I'm going to order soon. Again, I'm not finished with my studio. Now, if you're wondering what this is just a tablet, and this is running, I'm getting ahead of myself. It's running TouchDAW, which is a program that I can control Logic, but I'm getting ahead. All right, so over here, I think it's funny to mention it because it is a part of the studio, but this is a studio recording light. So when I hit record, that light turns red, and you can make it any color you want when it's playing. So right now it turns blue when I'm playing a music, but when I'm recording it turns red. It's just an indicator to let you know that it's recording, and I like it. It works off of USB, and it works with most DAWs, so you got to know what you're doing to create a control surface. It's basically MIDI, so you have to kind of like know what you're doing to set it up, but it's not hard to set it up. All right, as far as software, I'm running Pro Tools, but that's not my main software that I use. I use mainly Logic Pro X, and then I can mix in Pro Tools. I haven't created any songs yet in Pro Tools. It's no real reason other than I have like 600 songs in Logic Pro, you know, and I'm not willing to try to transfer all those songs into Pro Tools yet. Okay, I'm also using for video editing Avid Media Composer, and I'm using Final Cut Pro. And all those software packages is on this one computer. So one day I'm going to separate the audio from the video production. And that's what I was going to use these desks for, to do video editing. But I decided to put that upstairs. So what's going to go here is a new futon. I had an older futon that's in my office right now, but I've ordered a black futon for the studio. And it's kind of long, so I don't know if it's going to work properly. So we're just going to put it in here. I'm going to lose, you know, some space. I've already done the measurement, but you don't really know what you have until you put it in the space. So we'll see if that futon works in here or not. All right, so I'm running out of battery, so I have to kind of hurry this up. So where are we at? So now I could talk to you about the TouchDAW. So that's what this is right here. So I had a touchscreen I'm not even gonna mention the brand name. It was, it was not a big deal. It was a touch screen, it was a mixer, and it didn't like my multi-screen setup. There's nothing wrong with my multi-screen setup. That software did not allow for multiple monitors, so it was a design flaw. So I took it back, and then I'm going to get something else, and I'll talk about it when I get to it. But yeah, this is the Touch Doll. This is not the free version. This is a paid version. So I have the transport, so I can stop play and I can record. I can take this device and go over here and record if I want to. I can go into another part of the house and record and stop it and play and do whatever. So this allows me to be mobile. It runs off of wireless. It's not connected now because I turned off the wireless this morning on the computer, and I don't have Logic turned on. But if I turn on Logic, this thing will just kick in. It's kind of cool. And then on a cell phone that I'm using to record, I have a Logic remote, which does the same thing, but you only get one channel. And you can, record or whatever, and it has the transport. So it's kind of cool. I have multiple ways to remotely control Logic. All right, so the future, what's coming? What I have ordered is a Chaotica eyeball, a Chaotica eyeball. Now, most likely, I'm going to put the Chaotica eyeball not on the one in the studio because I already have the isolation, right? So the studio, which you're in it and you don't really hear no reflections, you don't hear no echoes. I'm going to put the Chaotica on this one, the one that goes in the hallway, because I didn't realize that when you're in the hallway, you do get the echo. You do get the reflections when you play it. When you listen to the headphones, you can actually hear the echo right up in this area. See, I can hear it reflecting off the walls, So I'll use the Chaotica eyeball on this one. Yeah, I know it's the most expensive one, but I'll put it there for that one. And then I got another one, the Outron, the cheaper one, they call it the Chinese knockoff, the Outron. And there's a few other brands out there that does the same thing. I'm gonna put that one on this one. And I want to see how it does inside the studio. I'm sure it's like kind of overkill for what I have. I just wanted to have one, period. So what I plan to have here instead of this sitting right here, this is just here temporarily. Sometimes I put this over there. But anyway, the Persona 16 fader port 16. Now the reason why I chose that is because I always wanted a device that I can turn the knobs, versus just a control surface where, it's on a computer. So I went back and forth, and when I turned in that other device, I decided that I want to get the Personas Fader Port 16, but I have to wait until I do something else before I can go purchase it. It's around, man, I think I forgot the price. I think it's, let's say it's under 2,000. It's under 2,000. No, actually, it's 1,000. It's actually 1,000. It's 99. It's 999. That's what it is. So I'm gonna wait until I gotta get my truck looked at, and once I get my truck squared away, then I'm gonna order the Personas Fader Port 16. Has the movable the motorized faders, and it's cool. I might have more than 16 channels or tracks on a song, but I just wanted a visual studio, mixer for the studio, and it'll fit real perfectly right here. I can probably even put it here somewhere, but I think I'm going to put it over here, and then whatever display it has, I can display it here. So that's what I meant by, having the DAW, the not the DAW, but whatever digital representation of that mixer would be displayed here. Okay, I also recently, I had not even thought about having this, is a Mackie Big Knob. Now, my friend Solomon, he told me, to get that
So that may even take the place of this because that the one the model that I'm going to get, it you can use it for talk back and you can use it for your headphone, you know, monitoring. So it's basically, you know, I help me monitor, you know, switch between the speakers. So it's a monitor controller. Another thing I'm going to get that I already have one, but I'm going to purchase one for the studio. I have one for my office. It's a Lacy drive. It's a more durable hard drive. And it'll take the place of these two hard drives that I have. So I have two, you know, large terabyte hard drives, but I want to get the Lacy drive. So it'll only be one USB versus using two. Well, one is for, you know, music and one is for video. But like I said, this is supposed to be only for music studio. And the last thing is I'm going to get a UPS. I don't know what model or brand, but I'll get a UPS system. And I wasn't going to mention this, but lastly, I was going to get a cable management. Right now, the studio is not finished. It's still in, you know, I'm still building on the studio, the new design. But you see all that cable like that there. It's all brand new. Most of the cable is brand new. It just doesn't look right. So once I get everything in the place, once I know all the wires, you know, that I'm going to have connected, or mostly the wires that I'm going to have connected, then I'm going to work on a power management system that'll make the wires look more neat. Basically, either I'm going to use something metal or it's going to be plastic, and it's basically going to allow all the cables to be straight and neat, because I really don't like the way that it looks. But anyway, that's my studio. I did that within 30 minutes. I don't have all the pieces that I want to make the studio complete, like the couch and, you know, the fader port and the big knob and this. But these are the small things, or they're not big things. I have all pretty much the big elements of the studio. So anyway, if you have any questions, if you have any comments, please like, share, subscribe, and let me know what you think about my studio. Let me know what you think about any product. Everybody has their own opinion about what to get, like the Chaotica Eyeball, and, you know, what is the right interface, and you know, just let me know what you think about the Renaissance. Remember, the Renaissance it's not a standalone. It requires a computer. So, you know, a lot of people have debates on what equipment that they have in their studios. All right, so this is Christian Robinson. Hope that you enjoyed the video. I'm out of here.